Let's bring in Daniel Wild, Deputy Executive Director of the Institute of Public Affairs. Dan, let's start with the Teals. They are not happy about the standards of behaviour in Parliament House. They had a press conference today saying proper standards are rarely seen. Let's hear from the woman who only last week called Peter Dutton racist in Parliament House.
Stop it at the top. At the end of the day, we hear a lot of talk about commitment to better standards, better behaviour, but that can only be modelled by the leadership. All those MPs take their cue from their leaders. They are elected leaders of their parties, from David Littleproud as the leader of the Nationals, Peter Dutton, the leader of the Liberal Party, Anthony Albanese, the leader of the Labor Party.
Dan, it's good that she knows who leads each party. That's refreshing. She didn't mention the Greens there, I don't think, but I do wonder whether this is a case of people in glass houses not throwing stones. It was literally days ago where she had to withdraw a comment calling Peter Dutton racist in Parliament.
That's right. It is the pot calling the kettle black. You know, just look at your own behaviour. Of course, the Teals are the ones that thought it was a good idea to divide the country by race in the Constitution, and they're going to lecture everybody else about parliamentary behaviour. You're right, she didn't point out the Greens. I suspect the reason for that is because the Teals are just cashed-up Greens. They vote, you know, analysis on Sky News yesterday revealed they vote with the Greens 60% of the time, Coalition a third of the time. So how are they really independent and representing the views of their community?
And I won't even pretend, like, it wasn't just that they were supposedly independent, but they portrayed themselves as conservative alternatives. They were conservatives that cared about the environment. That was kind of the narrative that was pushed. And they are nothing of the sort, as you've just explained.
No, look, that's exactly right. And they're a part of a growing cohort of these inner city elites that are not interested in a debate. They, you know, anytime somebody raises a different opinion, they will try and silence people and they say, oh, it's about parliamentary behaviour. Well, you're allowed to have a debate in a democracy, particularly in Parliament House, and they are not interested in debating the substance of the issues.
No, and to me it is tone policing. Where do they get off telling others how they can express themselves? Of course, you don't cross the line into straight-out abuse like Zali indulged in calling Peter Dutton racist, and he obviously wouldn't say anything threatening, but if you have got robust discussions happening in Parliament House, well, that's the place for it. I don't think that's something to hold a press conference about.